Hi, Trevor back again for the Hobby Organist, and we've made it to Friday. Here we are. And so Friday was going to be a styles day, but we've had quite a few requests for this particular video, and so we've had a bit of a change because we thought, well, we can do styles one day next week. But a lot of our E-Series owners, the Inspire, Rialto and Marquee owners and Arias, have all said, can you demonstrate one of the packs that you do for our organ? So we thought, yes, let's do the original Just For You pack. So this was the first setup pack that we did for E-Series organs. And we've already done a video where we did the Just For You Legacy Edition, which worked on the A-Series. And so we realised from all the requests we were getting that we actually hadn't covered the proper original pack that we did for the E-Series. So that's what we're going to do today, because on a Friday we've got lots of time for doing playing, and there's lots of stuff in this pack to go through. So I thought that'd be fun to do our Just For You software pack, which, as I say, works in all the E-Series, Inspire, Auto, Marquee, Aria and Aria Pro. And in fact, I'm lucky enough today to be sitting in front of a fantastic Lowrey Aria Pro. And so this is going to be good fun for me. I always joke, actually, with people that, working in a music shop, we very rarely get to sit down and play the organ. So that's probably why these videos for me have ended up getting longer and longer, because this is a good excuse for me to break away from the computer and the telephones and sit and play the organ, which is always good fun. And what better instrument than the best organ in the world, the Aria. And so weekly update. So far, we're up to 322 subscribers on the channel, which is fantastic. And nearly 37,000 views. So well done, everybody, for watching. And remember, at the end of the videos, if you like what you've seen, you enjoyed it, please click the like button and the subscribe button. I'm told that's what everybody has to do on YouTube now, and it makes you that makes you more popular on there, and you then get more views on top of that. It kind of is a cyclic thing. Anyway, on with the pack. So we have the Just For You software pack. This is probably the biggest pack we've actually ever did. It goes up to 25 different tracks, so there's a lot of registrations on here, so probably not best if I try and do every single one of them. So let's have a look what's on here. So we have Andre's orchestra, Andre Roux and his famous orchestra, magic musical registrations, and the first one I'm going to look at is Simply Strings. That's the first one that I did for this pack. So let's go to USB, load setups, and we're going to choose Simply Strings and do all. And so that's loaded them all into Bank A. And what I was trying to do with these registrations is just enjoy the sound of an orchestra and the beautiful sound of strings. In fact, strings is one of my favourite sounds. If you watch all the videos and things that I do, I'm always using the string sounds, and I just love the sound, and especially on organs you get these lovely. So I thought it'd be fun to do a whole bank of my sort of favourite kind of string sounds. And so they go from starting off with a nice light string. Is that the orchestral voicing, especially the strings, have just got better and better and better with each generation. And that is just such a lovely light string sound. Paired it up with a nice little violin down here. Get lost in that myself. As the orchestral singing registration, we changed over on the split point and having a nice solo flute, because again the flute sound on the E-series is gorgeous. Harmony strings. So remember all the videos we talked about harmony. So rather than doing those big chords, I'm doing here myself. We can use the harmony section. So with one finger, we did brilliant full orchestra. Of course, you don't always have to keep building and building. Your ending can go back. And one trick we're using there is a feature which we haven't actually mentioned in any of the videos yet, is a thing called MCS Plus. So again, I have to add this to the list of things to cover next week. We've got pedal magic and MCS Plus and styles. But MCS Plus is a really interesting thing. Very briefly, what it does is it adds some extra notes to your chords. So we're used to the harmony up there adding notes to your right hand. But the MCS Plus actually adds notes to your left-hand chord. So we're using it to fill out the chord in the left hand to make it sound fuller. If we zoom in a little bit, actually, just as a little pause, go off on a little tangent now. If you can see, when I play a chord here, it lights up with the notes I'm playing. I've got G, C, and E. But there's another note being played up here, another G. I'm going to play an F. F, A, C, it's adding F and A up here. And so what it's doing is actually adding as if I'm playing a two-handed chord in the left hand. And that, whoops, zoom back the other way. And that's having the effect of filling out the left hand. So you can hear those extra notes being added in as I turn it off and on. We'll do a video on that one, that feature it properly next week. But that's a little trick that we're using with these registrations, is to fill out and actually make it sound fuller, as we would do. When we're doing a big string sound, we tend to do two hands. So the MCS Plus is almost having the effect of having a two-handed chord in that left hand. To make that left hand sound fuller. So it's a great feature. And I'm using it in the background in all of these settings. There's a great one here, cello one, which is the cello section, which has a great sort of dark kind of... Number 9, we use the cascade feature. Remember, the cascade feature takes the harmony notes and makes them come down. But I'm actually, the speed of that harmony is always determined by the tempo. So I've got the tempo set really fast on this, so you hardly hear the cascade. So it's just it just adds a little bit of delay to the string sound coming in. Symphonic orchestra, we take all the strings and then put a lead violinist on the top. So we have a solo cello down here. And then when you come up here, you have the full orchestra. sound. When we talk about on the videos when we combine sounds together, the great thing about Lowrey is you can have all these sounds layered. And on the E-series you can layer these sounds, but they don't become too overwhelming. You still keep some kind of transparency so you can hear all the different instruments. So for me sitting at this, that's just such a lovely sound with the strings filled up behind. And we're using the harmony with the cascade, and it's safe. Got to play on that top half. If you play down here, it's going to be really dodgy. So that's a great set of string registrations. And what I would recommend for people, if you like using those sounds, but you want to mix them in with your own arrangements, look back on the video where we've said about loading in these registrations into a separate bank. So for example, you could take these string ones and load them into bank E. And then as you're creating your own registrations, which you may be saving in bank A or bank B, you can pick one of these out and then incorporate it as part of your registrations. You may not want to have the whole piece of music all being strings, so you can go to one of your registrations where you've done something else. And that's one of the nice things, actually, if you can load these registrations in these higher banks, you can then pick them out as you use them and put them together in your own order. So, yeah. So that's our Simply Strings. Yeah, some lovely sounds in there. Next one up, Dixie Parade. Let's do something completely different. Very, very happy music, a bit of Dixie solo stuff. I had good fun putting these sounds together. So we're using a lot of the editing and tweaking of the voices. So we take that trumpet there, we've brightened it up, we put a bit more attack on it. The fake it at feature on the virtuoso. Remember on the video where we described the virtuosos, you have the option of putting the fake it feature on the virtuoso, and so we've got it up there, and we've got a different one on the left hand side, because say on the marquee or an aria, you've got two virtuosos, so we did something different with both of those. So yeah, great fun, bit of Dixieland. So we're mixing two pianos together, we've detuned one of them so they're out of tune slightly of each other. We're using the harmony feature. And we've taken a style, the razzmatazz, that we were using at the beginning, and we've done this alteration that we were talking about in the previous videos, where we've got the auto style on, we've got the drum variation, we've taken out the orchestral plus, and we're left with this great stick playing, just with the vamping piano, and it sounds like we've got a bit of striped piano going. Banjo. if I was doing these registrations in the Aria, we'd now use the split fake it button, so we would maybe fake it to be down here on the lower keyboard. Which is great, but now because we can split this fake it feature, that can jiggle away where I'm at. Registration up, Dixie Piano Fever. We've done the game, but we were talking about in the previous video, we've revoiced the style. It's still razzmatazz, but I've changed the banjo that was in there to a piano. To go with a whole piano kind of feel. Okay, a bit of revoicing going on. We've taken it still we've gone over to the stride piano style, and we've got the drum variation to give us the sticks again. And we've changed the pedal sound to being like this blown pipe. And we've got the pipe sound, the bottle sound in the left hand, so it's like somebody playing the bottles for us. So we've become all acoustic-y. Whistle sound is the slide feature, which is a feature that's been around on organs for a long time. We used to call it portamento, bit of a mouthful that one. Slide describes exactly the same thing, and basically it means that when you play two notes legato, because this whistle sound is what we call monophonic, you can only play one note at a time. So normally when you hold down one note and press another one, it's going to yodel and jump to the highest note. And so when it does that, rather than it just jumping, it actually slides a little bit. We just stop the rhythm. And it gives that kind of more realistic feel than when somebody whistles. They're not very precise with their whistling. They're not going... I'm very definite with the notes. I can't really whistle. So there's a... Hear that? What are you getting there? Whistle sound normally, but then when we get to a point where we hold it down for at least a beat, it then does this wonderful cascade, so you've got like little people singing whistling in harmony. So I could be playing the melody, because that's only on one beat. Thank you. part of the registrations. We're actually adding more style, the Autostar gun drum variation, harmony going, all the different things. Right towards the end. These registrations were done before the RA came out, so before we had this split fake it, but that's a great feature to introduce on these registrations if you're using them on ARIA, because we've always got a solo sound down here. And so you can get that going, which is, I mean, Dixieland, more than any kind of style of music, is all about this improvisation. So to have that trumpet player improvising below us there is great. Ending number two. Ending number one does a great ending. They're both brilliant. They're brilliant job there from Bill doing fantastic Dixieland. So that's our Dixieland set of registrations called Dixie Parade. Great fun. What else do we have? We have the Sweet Miller registrations. Let's do that. Let's have a look at those next. Scroll up, Sweet Miller. Stuff together, just giving that full sound without it being too overwhelming. And what he's done with that clarinet sound at the top of that, he's added some extra vibrato, so it's got more of a so it's kind of wailing at the top of it, which is exactly. And of course, it carries on with tenor sax. Show what Lowrey organs are all about is having that big, lovely, lush sound without having to do too much work. I'm just doing one finger there on the upper keyboard. grand orchestra. I know you're not hearing it on the video because we've got a rubbishy camcorder, but that is just such a great sound. If you're lucky enough to have one of these packs, and this is the main reason for looking at this is to give us some fun stuff to play on the organ, but also to for people who have these packs at home, maybe you haven't used these registrations, or you've flicked through them and not at all, or you've had them and not used them very much. But please, if you've got this pack, put it in your organ, because it will transform the way it sounds and give you some fantastic sounds, just like the ones that we're playing now. Let's carry on. Back to USB. What one should we do next? Because I'm very conscious that I make these videos far too long. Let's have a look at Star Selection. Yeah, that's... where's that one? That's number 7. Another one of Tom's. I've done some Louis Armstrong here, A1. Yeah. Tom was very, very proud of this next one. He calls this one Lowrey Sings. I can kind of hear it there. A6 Mantovani. On here with a sack. Trumpet in there, wavelling away at the end. Just isn't that ending again? Brilliant. Tom's revoiced that accompaniment, so that wobbly trumpet is there in the ending. Brilliant. Let's move on. We're nowhere near halfway through. We're in on track 8. I've got to press on, otherwise I'm going to be here all day. Next lot, some great dance band selections. I'm not sure how much in America you're fondness of foxtrots and so forth, but it's a very popular style of music to play foxtrots, and quicksteps and slow foxtrots. And so Tom's done a selection of registrations concentrating on the kind of dance band kind of styles of the foxtrots. foxtrot there. The tempo down a bit. Using a style which generally comes up as being very fast, Swing of India, which is normally racing away. But you slowed it right down, taking the orchestral side out, so you just get this nice basic strumming. And bring the extra stuff in. That's the next illustration. Now, a bit of contrast, modern ballads. This is one of my ones. Let's load this one up, track 9. So, a selection of songs are registrations for playing modern ballad sounds. We said modern ballads, but we've got slow swing in there. let's see. The haunting ballad one is using one of my favourite sounds, the theremin sound with the meditation. And funnily enough, I said modern ballads, but that can work really effectively with some of the old standards. So. Sort of taking songs that you normally play in a particular style and playing them in something a bit different. So for example, on the modern Latin, we've got this lovely bolero de more style, which is this lovely romantic Spanish guitar playing there, and the percussion in there, the bongos and the congas. And we're putting there a nice guitar, and again you can play, you don't have to play a Latin song, you can play one of your slow swings in this kind of style when it works. Play a Latin song with this. I'm not saying you can't play, but it's fun just exploring. That way we look tonight again. Slow swing. This is actually setting up for the style we were talking about last week, the San Fran. So it's using it. Lovely saxophone. Next one uses a lovely 16-beat ballad. This is a style that Bill added on the A series when we had the Sterling edition, because he's never really had a 16-beat rhythm before, or a straight 16-beat, and so he did a fantastic job of writing a beautiful modern style. Kinds of ballads, really. We'll have to have a little bit of pause in the middle of this video because we've got up to track 9, we've got loads to go through and I want to show you as much as possible. But my camcorder is about to run out of battery, so I need to go and get it plugged in and I shall see you back just in a second. Hello, welcome back. Sorry about that little interlude there. We're all powered up and ready to continue with our journey through the Just For You pack, and we've got as far as track 9, and we were just playing some of the modern Latin and the 16-beat, and we just finished off. There's a great one here, we called it Beach Ballad. I had to remind myself actually what kind of sound we had for that, and this is a great style. They're called the Standby You style, which is obvious, very obvious what you could play with that, but we set up this great harmonica for playing that. See, it's lovely. Great style there. Stuff in there in the modern ballads. Let's move on to the next one, load setups. We did modern ballads. Let's do love songs. I love my love songs. Yes. We set up lovely. James Galway flute for playing the wonderfully Annie song, using a great style on here called Denver Picking. And again, all these techniques and things that we've talked about in the videos we're using all the time on these setups. So we're setting up the style there, but we've stripped it right back to just the basic. So you get this wonderful acoustic guitar accompanying you. America knows who James Galway is, but he's very famous in the UK for people of my generation, because he was known as the man with the golden flute. Not flute. Playing any song with that, but you can play all kinds of waltzes with that, just to give them a different kind of feel. That is a song that I was talking about the other day in the video with the theme from the Thornbirds. Different. Some of these, take a song and just approach it in a slightly different way. Romantic clarinet, romantic saxophone. Clarinet can be such a romantic instrument. It's got that lovely warmth and depth to the sound there. And we've brightened it up a little bit so you can hear a little bit of the reediness to it. Lovely woody kind of sound. And you put that with a nice slow kind of swing. And it's again great for playing all of those standards that, you know. And then we move on to a romantic piano setting. And we're using the romantic piano accompaniment, which is a gorgeous accompaniment. Piano, but we've also kept the strings in with it as well to give it that sort of backing, that kind of fullness. And again, you can play all your kind of Broadway ballads to that. Romantic organ, yeah. The organ can be a really kind of romantic and expressive instrument, electronic organ sound, because we're using this that great feature on Lowrey organs with the tremolo winding up, so you get this expression into it. So when it, you start off with a slow tremolo. It sounds sad. My take on this idea of phrasing, of how to get emotion into performance of music. And a lot of the time it's all about thinking about the emotion that's going in the song, what the lyrics are saying. Singers kind of have it easy because they have the words that people can hear and understand, and of course you naturally express emotion in your voice. We can't do that on the organ, obviously we can't play the words, but what we can do is we can very much play the phrasing of the words and try and capture the emotion as much as we can in our instrumental performance. And so with something like the organ sound there, you make the organ sound sad with that slow tremolo, and then you play the phrase it in a kind of lamentable way that you're kind of, maybe I didn't go, you kind of, rather than just going through it mechanically, you kind of have these pauses and falls to try and highlight, say, the emotion in the piece. We'll do a proper video on that another day, but just for the time being, this kind of setting is sounds for doing that, and that winding up of the Leslie is really effective on that, and that's another great style in there, the Always in Mind style. But you don't obviously have to play that song with it, you can use it. It's lovely for playing He Ain't Heavy as My Brother. Great. Turn the page, we're only up to number 10, we've got loads of people to get through. Luscious Latin Dance It. Oh, let's do Dance It. Let's do get the tempo up a bit. Dance It. There we go. So with the E-series organs, Lowrey are trying to bring us up to date a bit and have something with a bit more modern and kind of exciting and jazzy stuff going in it. So they've given us some great new styles, and it's nice to sort of show this more contemporary side to the Lowrey organ. So this is a great style. It's the Miami Rhythm. A great 12-bar introduction for Bill. Great if we're here in the summer, all the sun's shining. We'll be right back. playing a song there by Miami Sound Machine. The rhythm is going to get you. But the thing with these kind of styles, and I said this earlier on, is try playing anything with them. Try experimenting. Look at some of your samba type numbers or your Latin numbers, and jazz them up. And with this. Social distancing, they assume we must be having a party. So we've got this wonderful supreme shuffle, which is a great shuffle rhythm. Shuffle rhythms have this kind of dance beat to them. And there's all kinds of songs you play with that, obviously some supreme stuff. Stevie Wonder. Part-time lover from the film Lady in Red by the wonderful Stevie Wonder. This is a great style. This is a style that came along, I think, with Inspire, first of all, and the Marquee. And it's just a brilliant recreation of the famous Sting song, Every Breath You Take. And I've suggested other things to play with, but it also is great fun just playing the song. Sometimes it's just fun playing the song that goes with the style. And this is a brilliant style. I mean, that guitar in there and the way that the driving beat is just like the original. Brilliant job of capturing that. And it's a very easy song to play. you've got to play some disco stuff. And I love disco. And this is one of the things that there's probably a thing to remember of the talking about automatics and using accompaniments and so forth, is that sometimes, like I was talking about with the AOC, it doesn't matter how good an organist you are, it's easier just to use your automatics, or you can get something that you couldn't physically play yourself. And disco actually is one of those things. These modern rhythms, they need very, very strong and complicated or rhythmic bass lines. So for example, when I was playing the Every Breath You Take, the actual bass line in that from the accompaniment is this continuous dun, 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 dun. So my foot was having to work double time to sit there going. And you think, ah, for all of that hard work, you might as well just put your automatics on, it sounds the same. And what disco is a similar thing, is that disco rhythms tend to have, and from the 70s on, when disco was invented in the 70s, very distinctive bass lines that are very driving, very pulsy, and they kind of underpin all of the song. So when I was younger, not long, long, long time ago, I used to spend ages trying to practice playing these disco bass lines on the pedals. That's one of the early ones I learned. See how amazing my feet are dancing down there, but I'm actually having to use 2 feet to do that bass line that quickly. Or if we're doing the classic bass line for disco, is basically playing the octaves. You go, doesn't sound very complicated, but when you're trying to do it with your feet, you've got to use 2 feet. Now that's okay kind of doing that at the moment while I'm not having to worry about doing anything else. But when you're trying to play and do all the stuff on the organ, it's actually a bit uncomfortable just trying to do those 2 feet. So when I try and do the disco myself, I can do it with my 2 feet, but it's a lot of hard work, and it means I've got no controlled expression pedal because I need 2 feet to do it. But if I let the automatics do it, it does that very easily without me having to do all the hard work. So a lot of the time I would let the automatics, even though I could play that myself, I can let the automatics take over. In fact, the nice thing about the Lowreys, of course, is that you can start off doing it yourself, and when you do get tired and you stop playing the bass, it will take over for you. But let's try and do it with me doing it just half with, our disco stuff. Classic Pet Shop Boys song that they took the famous ballad we were just playing earlier and turned it into a disco. It was what I was saying about it. Take the song and play it in a completely different way. And it works really well as a disco rhythm. And they had a massive hit with this. So that's what these two registrations are all set about, for doing that kind of thing. Let's go, I Am Disco. what we did with those registrations, we use a really classic thing that we described in another one of our earlier videos, is the golden harp, to give us this amazing techno... So we took the golden harp, let them do it up and down, but we changed it to a symphony kind of sound. Fill out the whole disco experience, but yeah, I love that. Good fun. Bit of a workout. Now, where are we up to? That was number 12, so perfect pianos. Again, from all the videos, you've probably heard me do lots of stuff playing on pianos. To do some piano registrations, just setting up a full piano. A lot of people ask about, let's get rid of that golden harp, ask about piano registrations. And these Lowrey organs have the most gorgeous piano sounds in them. And we just put this like little bass underneath it as well. And make no apology for this, but if you really want the pianos to sound as good as they can, you need to have the touch on, because you need to have that expression that a pianist would have. That's another video for another day, in quite a list. But set that up on both keyboards. And the next registration, we put some strings down there with underpinning the piano. It's a choir up here. Registrations obviously are not really, these early ones are very much kind of professional kind of ones, because there's no automatics in there. They are all kind of designed for playing completely manually. But of course you could put your own style on with them and the automatics back in, so you're not, they're not completely wasted. But later on we move on to using the styles and the automatics, and so number 5 uses another beautiful pianist style called Heart Songs. I was just checking on there when that introduction started, something about it sounded a little bit different to me, and of course I just remembered I revoiced it to use a different piano sound to the one that it normally uses, and I think it just makes it a little bit clearer, the piano. So this next one is a 6/8 piano. 6/8 styles are the, you play them like a ballad, you count 1, 2, 3, 4, but they have this triplet feel, which is dun 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 dun. And we've taken that style and we've got the piano in there. We've actually taken what was the 6/8 guitar style and we voiced it to have a piano, so we've made our own 6/8 pianist style. Just simple with the piano. We've built it up in the drums and some strings. And there's just no end of songs you can play with that. Songs. Oh, perfect pianos, yes, perfect pianos, right from playing the straight piano to having some rhythm in there and revoicing accompaniments that you wouldn't normally have a piano sound in there. Classic country, we've done lots of country in lots of videos, so we won't do the classic country one because we are running out of time. Surprising styles, this is kind of what we've been talking about on Fridays, is finding styles that we wouldn't normally pick out. So number 15, surprising styles. Jumping jazz, yeah. Jumping jazz is a great style, introduced on the Prestige. And when that first came out, and I remember demonstrating this style to people and just being blown away by it, because a brilliant introduction, fantastic drum solo in it, a great altar style. It's just a fantastic style. So jumping jazz. Thank you. transpose yourself up one and do alter style, so when you come back to start playing you've gone up a key, and the style has then gone to alter style, which means it's got a lot more going on in it, so it's kind of really built up. We've had that style from the Prestige, it's been in all the organs, and it's still it's such a smile on my face. I remember when I first heard that one, that ending is brilliant. So you can play along with the ending. And then that alter style, there's a brilliant, again, that's just a saying the other day about listening to the styles, all the stuff that's going on, that alter style. Great piano dancing around. Ding behind it. Yeah, brilliant. There's going to be a bass player in there. That style there has had all that stuff going on for loud, noisy jazz stuff. Strip it back, and that brilliant, just strumming guitar and the tinkling piano. Absolutely great. That's jumping jazz. We said we're going to find some interesting styles today on a Friday. So again, what we've done here is taken the guitar swing and revoiced it to use the piano sounds, and then put a guitar sound with it. Tom's done with these. Swing and sway. That's the style I used several times, and I played it last week. Tom's done with this one. He's revoiced the saxophone part in it to use strings. So you get these lovely shimmering strings in the style. Have a listen. organ fun. I've done organ fun. Lots of revoicing. You see, he's taken the razzmatazz style we used earlier and done it with the organ sound. So brilliant. Let's move on.
USB load setups. So we did some theatre organ. Tom did some beautiful theatre organ registrations for this pack, the Mellow Theatre stuff. Don't want to start with this.
I sound like a broken record, but you can't hear the sound that I'm hearing from this organ. But the depth and the beauty of the bass and those voicings is incredible. When you play these registrations on the Lowrey organ live, it just sounds fantastic. So Mellow Theatre Organ, that was Drawbar Favourites. Amazed we put so much on this one, Drawbar Favourites. Here we go, track 17, a bit jazz. You know, when we talk about Drawbar Favourites, we're talking about Hammond organs. Stuff which I actually learned to play on the Hammond organ. My only teacher, a wonderful Muriel, had a Hammond organ that was the first organ actually properly played and touched. Actually, was this Hammond Aurora Classic, and that was a very long time ago. We're talking nearly 40 years ago, and back then the Hammond Aurora Classic was probably about £5,000. So for a 10-year-old boy, that was like being allowed to drive a Ferrari, I think, or a Lamborghini Countach. I think that was the dream machine at the time. And so I was amazed that I was able to touch and play that organ. Because you think £5,000 30-odd years ago, or 50 or 40, nearly 40 years ago, was an insane amount of money. And I really enjoyed my lessons. It gave me such the passion I still have all my life for playing the organ. So I love playing jazz organ. Sort of the showy offy jazzy organist type stuff. But of course you can put your own rhythm. Some great drawbar sounds done by Tom there. Next category is the much more laid-back, sweet Lowrey sounds. We always get lost loads of times from the DVDs and videos we do about the sweet Lowrey sound and getting that. And remember I said in the last video, we just add some sustain. But of course there are lots of things you can do around that kind of style. So we set up a load of presets that set up that lovely sweet Lowrey sound. And mix some strings with it. Without any rhythm, so that you can add your own style. That sounds. Oh.
Track from 1919, some easy basics. So a lot of people say that sometimes our registrations are got far too much going on, and if you're a learner, you don't want to have all that stuff. So we set up some really nice basic registrations using the basic styles on track 19. And then on tracks 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, we got the first time we ever did what we call the In Concert series, and we've explained this several times on the videos, but the idea of the In Concert series is to give you the registrations that I would use if I was doing a concert, and there are already endless videos actually on our main channel where I spend a lot of time chatting through how to use these registrations and play them. Probably the one that we haven't covered is the first one here, the DVD favourites, and this is probably in keeping with the hobbyist channel, so this is for all our fans of the Lowrey channel. These are registrations that we used on the DVDs when we originally recorded them, and we played our own songs. So on A1 there, we've got the Lowrey Fanfare registrations. Registrations for playing Even When. DVD a long, long time ago, and the Sensation had this fantastic style called Theatre Romance, and so this is a song I'd already written. I thought went very well with that style, and actually ever since we did that DVD, that's been the most requested song that people have asked, and what's that melody and what's that song, and it's been called Theatre Romance a lot because that's the style that comes up on the screen when we're using it, but the actual name of the song is called Even When. Anyway, number 7. This is the registration for the introduction to the Lowrey Prestige video. So if you watch the introduction to the Prestige, we had this great little introduction with the curtains and so forth, and we wanted it immediately on that video to sound different to all the other Lowrey ones and use these incredible new sounds that the A-series introduced with the Prestige. And so I set up this big string sound and using this new trumpet sound which we've never had before. And what I wanted to play was What a Wonderful World. But because of copyright restrictions on producing a DVD, we weren't able to. But so I wrote a song that sounded exactly kind of like What a Wonderful World. Well, what it does, it starts off with the same couple of notes, which makes you think it's leading into it, and then it goes somewhere else. I don't want to get myself into trouble. But and so a lot of people think we're playing The Wonderful World because it kind of starts off like that, but it's a different kind of song. But it uses that this great string sound. Oh, which we didn't set up on this registration. After all that talking about it. We've got the trumpet. Thank you.
Fable of a Wonderful World, but the actual song should be, that was originally from the DVD. The Stardust theme, which we've played many times now, is famous really, playing with the Vegas big band style. And here's a great thing, that introduction is changed completely by having the drum variation on. And again, we revisit so many different ideas and because they work so well. And this idea, the drum variation, not only changes the drums while the style's playing, it changes the drums while the introduction's playing. So without that on, the introduction sounds like this. Great. But if you have the drum variation on, you get this wonderful doom 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 with the drums. In fact, it's great fun. If you press the drums only button so you're not hearing any of the other bits and pieces and you put the introduction on, it's great. So the rest of this package is in concert series, and these are all registrations we've kind of covered in the other packs, really. Things like Good, Bad and the Ugly, and we've played that before, The Lion King, Frank Sinatra. So let's play a couple of them. Let's do the Chariots of Fire one. I don't think we've done that on any of these demonstrations, because that's a unique one, really, to the E series, and especially the Marquee, because the Marquee has a particular style set up for playing Chariots of Fire, and it really is a brilliant style. And when I was doing these registrations, I wanted to have a bit of a spacey kind of feel to give us this immediate impression that the E series are much more contemporary and more space age, I suppose. It's very childish of me, really, but so we start off this one with this lovely. Just for hours. This great choir and this lovely bass and this what they call a sweep, which is a sound that goes that kind of. Fire. is a very long sustain on that piano set. So that's a taste of really all the stuff that's in the Just For You pack. We actually haven't played through half of what's in here. 25 tracks. I can't believe we did so much stuff on here. This has got to be, without question, the best value pack that we've ever done. So if you don't have this for your E-Series organs, definitely worth having, because it gives you all that fantastic stuff to play and all those amazing sounds. If you've already got the pack, hopefully it's inspired you to go and pick it up again and have a look through and have another look at these registrations and enjoy them. I hope you've enjoyed just me playing through the different sounds and things. I certainly have. It's always good fun sitting here and playing the Lowrey organ. So have a good weekend. I haven't got any homework for you this weekend. Actually, there was one piece. I was going to ask you as a challenge. I put the challenge at the end to see how many people watch it all the way to the very end. At the very beginning, I was playing with the strings. They're simply string settings, and I played this melody. So see if anybody over the weekend can recognise what this song is. Anybody who's watched this video all the way to the end, if you haven't fallen asleep by this point, see if you can work out what that song is. I remember hearing it when I was a child being played by another organist, and I was desperate to find a musician, and I couldn't find it. A very kind person wrote it down for me, because I was only a child, and so I could learn to play it. So I've been playing that song for about 40 years. So there's the challenge for you. So have a good weekend. Stay safe. I think the weather's going to be lovely this weekend. I hope this video hasn't been too long. I've gone on for a long time, I imagine. But so that's the thing about the organs. You sit down and 5 minutes turns into 10 minutes. It turns into an hour. It turns into the whole day gone. But who cares? We've got nothing else to do. So keep safe, keep well, and I shall see you again on Monday. Thanks for watching.